Damn it. Fucking puppets.
Oh my god. Who is this?
Yes, we're ready to start filming the Nintendo digital event for...
What the fuck?
Thank you. I will head...
I'm scared.
...to the stage.
I mean, I guess they got Rooster... They got Rooster Teeth again? What the fuck?
I need to see a gif of that in 5 minutes.
Yeah.
Always told in my kindness that everything we ever knew could end.
Reggie,
yeah,
are you ready for the digital event?
God damn it.
Nintendo. Oh my god.
Let's not go to Bomber One.
Oh my god. No.
Puppet body is ready.
God.
My puppet body is ready.
God.
Reggie. This is fucking... This is great.
Alright, they win. Just end it right now.
Nintendo won!
They have the best openings now.
Yeah, they do.
They do. So last year's was really good.
They're so goofy and fucking retarded. I love them.
I'm here.
I'm here!
Nintendo just doesn't care anymore.
He always has a smile on his face.
Maybe if they spent more time making games than these, they'd be doing good.
Yeah.
Dang.
I wish they turned this into a game.
Mr. Miyamoto?
Oh, yes.
Oh, they turned her into a fucking Muppet.
God damn it. I love everything right now.
I just have to remember my wife.
He's a fucking furry. I knew it.
Oh my god.
Look. Star Fox, I like it. It's Star Fox, let's do it.
It's Star Fox.
Oh, you're right. Oh, he's Falco.
Oh, he's right. Oh, he's Falco. He's Falco. Holy shit.
Oh.
Oh no!
Flippy!
Star! Oh no, he's Star Fox! Oh, he's Where's Slippy? Who's gonna be Slippy?
Oh, it looks just like the cover! Oh fuck, that's awesome.
Yeah.
How did they start running like in the beginning of Star Fox 64?
Where the fuck is Slippy?
Yeah, where is Slippy? This is some bullshit.
What the fuck is Slippy?
Who's gonna be Slippy?
Hey, Fox, do a barrel roll.
Barrel roll? I can do better than that. Check this out.
That's scary.
Get the fuck out of my face.
Alright, let's do it.
Ooh,
I'm
yeah!
Sure.
Yes,
it's
Zelda.
Yes, I want
yes! Nintendo won!
Holy fuck.
Oh, yes, thank you. No fucking shooting on foot. Star Fox, it's back! Oh no! Oh, that's the worst thing I've ever seen. Oh, that's better.
Yes, it's awesome.
Now it's good. Yeah. Oh, he's on foot. Kinda. I'm upset now. Okay. I guess I could deal with this.
As long Where are the dinosaurs?
Yeah, no, please. Please don't. Where's that purple bitch he falls in love with thing, I guess?
Yeah.
I loved her. She was my favorite. Oh, no. I thought that thing was dropping,
A Star Fox?
Yeah. I thought he was dropping Fox in there.
Switching to all range mode. Let's take the
Yeah. Yeah. Classic. Yeah, I wanna! Star Fox what? Zero! Yeah. Holiday!
Is that a prequel?
Oh, okay, well, developer story. That was a good way to introduce Star Fox.
I live right by the Fushimi Inari Shrine. I've had a relation with Shenmue. The shrine since I was a child.
We're married.
It's got a dirt face going on.
I felt that I was always protected, as if it's my guardian angel. When I was a child, there was a TV show about fighter planes called Thunderbirds. That inspired me to make a game that had cinematic
Still talking
elements,
about Star Fox.
With each character having a distinct personality and their own drama. That would be reflected in the dialogue and appear in scenes like where a cool character and enemies would appear.
I'm here for a job, of course, and looks like I get to have a
what the fuck? I thought that was Wario for a second.
About details regarding how to make the main characters look and feel. We talked about all sorts of types of people. But ever since I was in school,
so we picked goofy and retarded
humanoid animals.
Oh, perfect.
And decided that the characters in this game should be based off animals. I then talked about it with Imamura-san, the designer, and we thought about the fox image. Then I thought, let's try making a fox the main character.
We're entering Corneria City now.
When there's an arch, you want to go under, right?
No.
That's the kind of game I wanted to make.
Over it, maybe. It still says Sony for my stream.
For the row of arches.
Oh well.
So we went with this idea to create a game where you would fly through different arches.
It's like Superman 64.
It's like Superman 64.
A game where you use a control stick, like the one you'd find on a plane. When you fly a real plane, you need to pull back on the control stick to fly up, right? Similarly, you can use the gyro on the gamepad to look all around and feel really immersed in the game.
No.
Yeah, it's true.
We'd like people to play as if they are flying a real plane.
I can't wait until I get a copyright strike from Nintendo for this.
For Wii U, with its two screens, we experimented with gameplay with ideas before this iteration of Star Fox.
Star Fox.
There were two screens that each serves a specific purpose. For example, we've tested using one screen for a more cinematic view and the other for gameplay. The Wii U gamepad has a gyro, and it's a big reason we decided to make this game.
I love gyros. Tastes great.
So it feels like you're in the cockpit like this. You can aim by moving the gamepad around.
Not doing that.
In the other Star Fox games, you play by controlling the third person on one screen.
Are you a kid or a squid? Probably neither, because you're a bitch.
I'm a dead.
You're a bitch, that's what you are. Alright, Iwata?
Dude, does that mean you can play first person and third person at the same time?
Yeah.
Yeah, no. You can be
really fucking meta.
Yeah, you could. So that's actually true. I can't wait. Can't you see how excited I am?
On the Nintendo 64 system, you had to use a lot of buttons. But now, with the Wii U gamepad, you can use two sticks to do things like speed up and flip around.
What? That's incredible, man.
All the different weapons. So there are four buttons left, and with that, we thought, why not use these buttons to make
Nintendo One. Last Guardian, more like my ass Guardian.
Other for U-turn.
That's cool.
The R-wing transforming into a walker.
That was Walkers. What fucking dead confirmed.
But oh, shit.
Since that game didn't make it out, I'm glad we were able to have it appear.
What?
The R-wing transformation mechanic actually
do break
like
its legs.
It makes a lot of sense.
Yeah, there you go. That makes sense.
There's the
Landmaster!
Landmaster! Hey, do a barrel! ever old.
The gyro wing, which adds a lot of breath to gameplay.
Breath?
With it, you can perform a lot of tasks as Fox. You can also play different stages with other vehicles, too.
But you're never walking around, I hope.
Horses with different vehicles, even after you clear the game. We've rebuilt the game using ideas from the past, but it's not a part 4 or part 5.
How long is this supposed to be?
Remake either. So we 3 hours.
Star Fox Zero
this time. No.
Oh no.
The subtitle Zero was taken from how the kanji character looks in calligraphy. Star Fox is based off of the Japanese culture that inspired me. So I wanted people around the world to see this cool kanji character in the logo. When I saw it, it reminded me of a foxtail. We wrote the character with a brush and added the logo. It looks cool.
Star Fox Zero. Oh, a Splatoon?
Hi, no. And welcome to Nintendo's digital event for E3 2015. I'm Reggie Fils-Aimé, president of Nintendo of America. We began today having a little fun imagining ourselves as characters in the Star Fox universe.
Dust that shoulder off. Can someone make a gif of that?
It also represents a theme you're going to encounter consistently throughout Nintendo's experience for E3. That theme is transformation. Recently,
Transformers confirmed.
Has made several announcements on how Nintendo itself is being transformed.
Really?
With expansion to Universal theme parks, mobile devices, and our new dedicated game platform, codename NX, which we'll tell you more about in 2016. Today, our purpose is more immediate, to focus on the transformations you'll be enjoying right
I get it, like a Star Fox thing.
In the coming
because you could transform into
if
a
there's a secret
legs.
To the longevity of Nintendo franchises, it is transformation. We never let them stand still.
Yeah, you do.
There always has to be something new, something compelling. And that even applies to the game Super Mario Brothers.
What?
Oh.
Which is celebrating its 30th anniversary in 2015.
Don't say new Super Mario Brothers 3.
Transformed over the years is obvious. But along the way, he's also
he's never had a gun.
Mario Maker.
From establishing the platforming genre.
They could give him a gun in the next game.
To the 3D world of Super Mario 64. Later this year, Super Mario Maker will take the next step.
No, it's called Super Mario Maker now.
The essence of game creation over to you, our fans. Now, players will become creators as you build your own Mario levels that can be shared globally.
That's cool. Can you release it?
And who knows?
I feel like I've been hearing about this game for fucking years.
Well, you have. It's been like 2 years.
Has it?
Finally.
I don't care.
Nothing in our history has
well, remember they probably announced it during a regular direct, probably earlier last year.
And as you'll find out this week, there are more new amiibos.
Yeah.
And more games.
More amiibos. That's why I love Nintendo.
Go, Sparsky, go.
Get him, hurry up. Please, one Star Fox amiibo.
I wish all those were made out of NES amiibo.
Yeah, well, there was like a huge line of like 16 NES amiibos in the previous thing. Digital event. It was mad.
The team put me right to work.
Yeah,
so
me
I'm
too.
Pleased to be here with
except
Karthik
I don't
Bala
care.
From the
Karthik Bala?
Hold on, hold on, what?
And Karthik, we've got some great news to
well, be quiet.
Yeah, Botswana?
So the hallmark of the Skylanders franchise.
Skylanders?
Oh, there's a Skylanders game for amiibo. That's going to be awesome.
And the highest quality
yeah, that'd be cool.
For the first time, we're bringing a whole new toy category to life, bringing vehicles to life this
oh,
year.
Oh, vehicles.
With our new game, Skylanders.
I'm gonna shit.
And
shush.
Really blending it to this epic
can't
vehicle
wait.
Adventure. But there's more to it, right? We've got two
need
unexpected
this.
Guest stars. So introducing.
Oh my god, it's fucking.
Donkey Kong.
What
and
the fuck?
It's Donkey Kong.
Vehicle. The barrel
blast. It's the barrel bowl.
Fuck. Barrel fun.
You kidding me?
Nope.
This is Hammer Slam Bowser.
Don't care. Oh my god, Bowser!
There's Skylander amiibos.
Yep.
Marsky, this would have been the easiest way to like transition back over.
Fuck it's like, everything.
It's like mixing chocolate with peanut butter.
Smartsky, you're gonna buy Skylanders again.
I don't wanna.
Ooh.
Of powers and abilities, some of which are natural, things that you would expect, like Donkey Kong throwing barrels, and Bowser slamming down his hammer, but also really unexpected moves that harken back to elements of lore within the 30 years of history of these characters.
Why don't they just make like a Skylanders-like game, but with
for
amiibo?
Yeah. Yeah. That's what we're announcing here for a second, but nope.
Yeah, I wish they would. Like a
wait.
A Smash Brothers kind
of. Motherfucker.
So now they're amiibos.
So again,
all right,
son of a bitch.
They're amiibos that can work with a game I'll never play. So they're just amiibos. Well, at least, hey, as long as they're the same price as regular amiibos.
You know what? They'll be easier to find, though.
Yeah,
because Skylanders you never fucking not find.
There's some of them you can't, but it's very,
most
very, very, very,
most of them are very, very common.
Yeah. Yep. Cool, I'll get it then. Aren't they cheaper, too?
No.
They're probably going to be more expensive
because
they go with two different
Skylanders are usually more, actually.
Are they how much?
For a little figure, like an amiibo, is $10, so a little cheaper. But then if you want to get the bigger ones, or the more, like, the special ones, like the legendary ones, they're like
$14.99. You know, this his fire
out now
becomes this insane flame.
Yeah,
we
sure.
We want to set the Koopa on fire.
You know what I like?
And they said use
Amiibo.
If they announced another fucking game that I care about.
For dry bones. It was just,
you know, building on top of that. And
so far, this and Sony both decided to show me some Skylanders shit that I don't care about.
Thank you so much for sharing this information. And throughout the entire week, we're going to be sharing more and more information. You and your team are going to grace us at Nintendo Treehouse Live, and there's going to be a lot more information to share.
I'm super excited.
Fantastic.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thanks. Bye, Reggie. Oh, hi, Reggie. Mario gets what the fuck?
I like it.
I do. Yeah. I like
just watch this the entire time. I'll do it.
Oh, they should make some Muppets movie of Reggie. Oh, Zelda! It's Zelda! Where's Metroid? Bring in Metroid. He's great. Whoa! When one hero isn't enough. Oh.
Oh, it's like four swords, three.
Oh! I thought it was some Mario Maker shit. No, it's not. It's actually a different game. I don't know why the fuck they did that. It made me confused.
It's Totem Time.
Oh, they're gonna use, like, 3D and stuff. I like Four Swords Adventures. Except this looks like Three Sword Adventures. Hopefully,
oh, Dolph can afford to... That, Game & Watch movie was cool, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah, I like it. Better be the same price as everything else.
Yeah.
Lucky fuckhead. Lucky. Lucky about what? You just got hit. You just got hit. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Shenmue 3 confirmed. Oh, wait. Wait, did that get funded?
Yeah. Yep.
Yeah, that's what I figured. Because it was at 16 million. Yeah, sure. 1.6 million when I went to bed.
Yeah.
I was like, yeah.
It's at like 2.2 million right now.
Ah, shit. That's never going to get made. That sucks. Well, maybe next time.
I just laugh. It was a dollar off.
Okay, I think we spent a little bit too much time with this. Alright, I think we're done anyway. Yeah, there you go.
Yay!
Fall, come on, man! You should have said it's on now. Go get it.
Yeah.
Nintendo. Oh, we're going to see Zelda? Wait, hold on.
Hello, I'm Aonuma, the producer of Zelda.
Yeah, what the fuck?
I'd like to talk about The Legend of Zelda, Triforce Heroes.
Oh.
The latest Nintendo 3DS
fucking
Zelda
assholes.
Game.
I thought we were done with that. Shikata, here to introduce me. They said they weren't going to show the new Zelda, so that's why I was surprised.
I wanted to focus on multiplayer and co-op. Multiplayer in past Zelda games was more competitive, much like a party game. Everyone would gather to play to see who would get the most rupees. This time, I wanted players to cooperatively enjoy more serious gameplay elements, like solving puzzles and going through dungeons.
The 3D visuals of A Link Between Worlds was a great feature, especially in terms of depth. So I wanted to incorporate.
Oh, he's got chainsaw. That's really violent. Oh, what a buddy.
They said Amiibo are about to show up in a totally unexpected way. My friend goes, "You mean in stores?"
That was good.
Co-op was fully realized with the totem mechanic.
Totem.
You can carry your friends on your shoulders and reach higher places.
A four-player totem was too tall, so we decided three was the better choice. For single player, there are
single player
like characters. There are two of them, and you can beat a level by switching between Link.
Oh my god, get this goofy fuck off the camera.
The story starts in a kingdom that is just
let's talk about Mario Maker. People. I can't even read that, it's in a foreign language.
So the king is looking for a hero who could
help.
That's
in Spanish.
So
I can't read Mexican.
Claiming to be the hero, and so it begins. Using items to defeat enemies and conquering dungeons is a familiar staple from other Zelda games.
I'm bored. So far, it's just the same shit.
It should appeal to fans of the series. This time, there's also a fashion element.
What?
Collect items to create new outfits with new abilities.
Oh my God!
Buying and equipping like just different clothes.
Cross-dress.
Your abilities change, so the same courses Shut will offer up. Different experiences
I know.
Depending on what you wear.
This game sucks.
Like he's cheering with pom poms.
Yeah, what a Woo! What a I fag.
With people in online multiplayer where you can't see their reactions as Lord. Well too. I hope people enjoy others to try out the game with them as
Twinkie's
well.
Dick, or whatever his name is. Yay. Mayday.
When playing in multiplayer, we frequently hear Mr. Onuma yelling excitedly about the game.
I have the loudest voice on the team.
Thank you.
I have the loudest voice on the team.
Yeah, Donald also Trump announces he's running for president, though.
We have another new game.
Okay,
hashtag Zelda.
I couldn't give a shit less.
Sam was complaining about E3 all day yesterday, right, Smartsky?
Yeah.
Alright, I gotta go. Jeb Bush is gonna have a press conference right now.
Oh,
bye.
Wait, hold on. Hyrule Warriors is coming to 3DS.
Yeah, they already announced that.
Oh, shut up. I don't look at leaked shit like a pussy.
No, they announced it.
I don't look at things like a pussy. What is it called? Hyrule Warriors, EXE, Combat Evolved, or something?
Like, honestly, like, I'm super excited to play this on 3DS.
Oh, I thought you were going to say, but I'm not going to buy it or something.
Hyrule Warriors is not like the Zelda.
Does that make sense?
It is an experience only.
No, this is pre-recorded, King fucker. Christian. Oh, it is called something different. Hyrule Warriors Legends.
I hope you will enjoy Hyrule Warriors Legends, as well as The Legend of Zelda Triforce Heroes on Nintendo 3DS.
Okay.
I'm kind of surprised that isn't like a new 3DS exclusive. I feel like it would be.
Alright, so three games so far. Only one I'm interested in. I like Zelda, but I'm not going to go play me a game I already played that I didn't care for, and a game I won't be able to play because I have no friends. Don't laugh. It's really sad. Yeah, we know. We've seen this game before, guys. Hyrule Warriors, I'm a legend. That's Sigma said. Why have they got the translator speaking like a sinner? Yeah, why did they get the translator to speak like an idiot? He spoke like really slow. Cool. When is that?
Today.
Oh no, Zelda, don't take that out. Oh my God, it's a fucking what? Why? It's a fucking port. Just bring it out. Why first quarter of next year?
Why? What was that?
I don't fucking know. No, what was this?
Star Fox.
I wish it was Beyond Good and Evil too.
Oh, it's the game from yesterday.
Oh, Blast Ball or fuck.
Yeah.
Ball of no, it's Metro Prime Federation Force.
What?
No, fuck you. Suck my ass. This isn't the fucking new Metro game I heard. Shut the fuck. Shut the fuck up.
It fucking finally happened.
No, shut the fuck up.
You little baby.
First of all, Metro Prime can suck my ass. Shut up, fuck you faggot. Oh, Trials fails. Oh, so that was fucking Metro Prime. I knew
it. So it was Metroid Prime there.
I knew it. I fucking knew it. Because it looked just like Metro Prime.
Yeah.
Alright, so two games that I don't go off. Oh, okay. Next year for two games that are probably complete and probably shit. So cool. How about we announce a real Metroid game?
Metroid Prime.
How about a real fucking Metroid game? I'll take a Metroid Prime game. I don't give a fuck. That's some bullshit.
Ooh. Fire Emblem.
Oh my God, look at her. She's hot.
She's wet.
Oh yeah, I bet she is.
Somebody get this bitch a towel.
Wait, hold on. That is a girl, right?
Yeah.
I have to make sure. Animes her a little.
She got the breasts.
I couldn't tell. Men have breasts too. Like Sam. You're
my child now.
Oh, okay. This looks pretty good so far. Oh, it's on 3DS.
Don't look at me.
That's okay, I wasn't.
Look at me.
Might actually try to get into this one. What was it called? Fates, yeah, okay. 2016, of fucking course.
Kill me if you want, but do it as yourself.
Oh my god. Is this Persona?
No.
Shut the fuck up. No, it wouldn't be Persona. It's all with you.
Oh, I love anime.
I love anime!
Shin Megami Tensei, Cross Fire Emblem.
Is it really?
Yep.
Oh yeah, that's right. They announced it a few months ago, right? Well, not announced it, but they showed a new trailer. Oh man. My two favorite animes.
Whoa, that
breast jiggle. So hard.
Didn't know they're showing profanity and pornography.
Yeah.
Nintendo.
It's Nintendo in a nutshell.
Yeah, man. Yeah. Let's do that all the time. Atlas, they make my favorite anime games.
They better show some Bravely Wrong. Second shit.
You're a shit.
Bravely Thirdly.
Fuck you. You shit out your own ass.
Shit out my ass.
All right, that our word is happening.
Well, yeah, it's in Chinese.
Arabic.
Right? It's in Egyptian. So, hieroglyphics.
So, I'm gonna download all my Xbox stuff. I forgot to download last night.
Well, all the games you'll never play.
Banjo-Tooie, yeah.
Yeah, you'll never play that.
I download that.
I don't know what that was supposed to be. Is this on Wii U?
Yep.
Okay. At least they have one game.
Fee.
Fee.
Hey guys, it's Fee.
Hey, right. Fee 5-4, fuck.
Fee.
Oh. Oh. Remember the old banana?
That was
it. Those are just transitions. Like, alright, what is this?
Destiny.
Mass Effect.
Yeah. Oh, it's
Xenoblade Chronicles.
Oh, it's, yeah, Xena.
Xenoblades.
Xena
World.
The guy's scout.
Spoilers.
Xenoblade. These puppets are great.
This game actually looks pretty good.
Yeah, Fragus anime.
I guess anime.
Oh, the last one was really good. Hopefully this one isn't rare. Ooh, dinosaurs. Ooh, lightsabers. Yeah. Oh, December.
Ooh, Christmas.
Wow. Games usually never come out for fucking December. Unless it's a shitty Ubisoft game. Oh, Animal Crossing. I already hate this.
Gonna officially announce the new Animal Crossing amiibos?
No, please stop.
Yeah, they're going to.
It's almost as worse as just an Animal Crossing game. I hope Sam has an erection right now. Not you, the fat one.
No.
No, well, he's watching Jeb Bush. So.
There's voice acting in here.
I don't hear voice acting. Not yet. Where's Troy Baker? We need to give him $5 so he can voice everybody.
Troy Baker as KK Slider.
As the kangaroo. Or where the fuck that's supposed to be. Alright, so this is a new Animal Crossing, right?
Yep.
Let's guess the subtitle. I'm gonna say, brand
Animal
new
Animal Crossing
leaf.
House Hunter.
House Hunter. Brand new leaf. Oh, I guess it's called Happy Home. That's what it's a hashtag. spoilers. Oh, Happy Home Designer.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, big fucking surprise. Oh, thank God.
Everything's fucked.
Oh, my dude, favorite is party. But with, like, Animal Crossing.
Yep.
Yeah.
You fucking nailed it.
So Mario Party.
That means it's the worst thing
Mario
ever.
Mario Party.
It's the worst thing ever. Oh my God, I'm so bored. Is this all they could think of? Is this a board game?
They should have Animal Crossing with guns.
That'd be amazing.
Make it grimy.
But I'm not buying any of these amiibos.
Yeah, you are.
Fucking hate all the characters from Animal Crossing.
You're buying,
where's
you're
the
buying,
villager?
You're buying one.
Yeah, wait, hold on. Yeah, where's the villager? Where's the reprint?
That's not fair.
The excitement is boring me.
Amiibo Festival.
Oh my God! Thank God it's coming out this year. Oh, what's gonna be it now?
Yoshi!
Yoshi! Finally, Yoshi's epic bullshit. I want that yarn amiibo.
Hi, I'm Emi Watanabe, and I work in software planning and development department at Nintendo. And I am a coordinator. I
you know, you want those merch.
I ain't go buy any of those amiibos.
I am.
Kirby's Epic Yarn with the same developer.
And I'm gonna buy this amiibo, let me tell
you. Yoshi?
Yeah.
They're gonna release Yoshi versions of all of the currently released amiibo, and I will buy them all.
And that's why you fail.
Yeah.
Even Gold Mario?
I'll probably do it too.
So fuck no.
We'll fail together.
Look, that's the entire amiibo collection they have in front of them right now.
You know what? I don't even.
All the ones they ever made, so get ready.
I don't even like Yoshi games, so I hope this one's good.
In the actual game. So, and the development team was really, really working hard.
It looks really cute.
To myself. Oh, is there anything that I can do in some way to help this?
Did they just show Yoshi getting hung?
And I didn't even notice. And I decided to make my very first yarn Yoshi. When I brought it back to the office, the smiles on the face of my colleagues really struck me. There was this proposal made at Nintendo saying that maybe for a game like this, a plushy amiibo would be more fun to have because you know, it goes well with the vibe of the game. Mm. And when I heard that, I fell in love with that.
They announced a bundle.
And decided to make more yarn Yoshi.
With a Yoshi amiibo.
Yoshi himself is made of yarn. The shape of his body transforms into different shapes. So he turns into like a propeller when you jump. And he turns into a mallet when he does the ground pound. But also the world itself is in yarn and fabrics. And lots of textiles. We have places in the game where you can unravel, and you can also knit platforms. And in this game, the enemies are made of yarn as well. So when Yoshi swallows them, they turn into little yarn balls instead of eggs. Well, most of all, we want the game to be fun. Yoshi's Woolly World provides plenty of challenge if you try to go for 100% completion. But also, we wanted to have lots and lots of people enjoy the game, and those lots of people have different expectations on the difficulty of the game. And for us, what's so special about Yoshi games is that the difficulty level is all up to the player, because if you just want to have fun, you can just run through the levels. If you think you're a more advanced player, you can set the challenge a little higher by collecting lots of items, and that provides plenty of challenge in this game.
What?
We're very confident that the game provides both the challenge and the fun.
How's that up the challenge? Collecting coins.
Its co-op mode is designed so that the user can decide how they want to play with their friend. So you can either cooperate with your friend, you can help each other out, you can swallow the other Yoshi, turn him into a yarn ball, and then throw it to higher.
That's cannibalism.
So that the other Yoshi can reach that.
He spits him out.
You can do a little bit of a competition.
That's gross.
With your friend. You can be a little mean.
I know, he poops him out.
I bet he spits on these pussies before he eats them.
And if you use it in Yoshi's Woolly World, then Yoshi's design turns into.
Do you think Yoshi has a digestive tract that's just like a tube? So he shits out
it's a piece of yarn.
I guess I'm showing that one. That one looks terrifying.
It's piece of yarn. Yeah, he looks fucking awful. What the hell is wrong with him?
If you have an amiibo at home, maybe you can have some.
Oh, that one's cool. I like that one. Even though it's bullshit ass paint job.
In this game, when we turn Gucci into
it's yarn, a bullshit ass.
Hey, yeah, that little fucking idiot. That fucking big lip dog. Come here, baby.
So now Yoshi can ride on something else.
Aha. Uh-huh. Get it? The stick. This yarn dick.
It's really fun to go back, revisit
that. Yeah, Samus Yoshi looks cool, I guess. That you missed out on. Except I don't remember Samus turning into a motorcycle.
It would be great if you can collect all the items in one
go. Confused there.
But that is quite challenging. So I hope people can enjoy playing the same level over and over again.
So why is this coming out? It's been out, like, it's been announced since, like, 2013. October, okay.
Okay, cool.
I thought it'd be earlier. These things are fucking stupid. I love them. Ooh! Oh. Jesus. This is Digimon.
No Crony 2.
Yeah, Digimon. When I saw level 5, I got excited. It might be like a Ni No Kuni game. Yo-kai watch. Yo-kai a little better now? Oh, that's some great voice acting. This is Digimon in the Obama years. I guess they're really looking for the next Pokemon.
It's good times though.
Yeah, this looks great. This and Fossil Fighters, I can't wait.
Really? I'm excited.
For this?
No.
Fossil Fighters has been out for like 3 months, so you better
go. Better go help them out.
Yeah, I don't think anybody's buying their games. Yo-kai Watch, okay. Oh, Paper Mario! Oh! That's pretty clever.
Mario and Luigi.
Yeah, but it's Paper Mario and...
Gord, can you just calm down?
I can't. Oh, no! He's paper. I don't like regular Paper
Mario. That is crossing over Mario games and Mario games.
Yeah. Next, you're gonna tell me that Samus is gonna fight Master Chief. I hope they make out. Oh my god. Is that what it's called? Hashtag Mario Luigi?
It's like ultimate Mario fanfiction. Combo shit.
Combo
but
shit.
But where's Paul Blart? God. I don't see any Paul Blart.
He's awaiting Smash Brothers.
Paper Crab Mario, that's pretty funny. Doesn't look nearly as shitty as it would look if anybody actually made a Paper Crab. Mario and Luigi Paper Jam. Of course it comes out next year.
What are we gonna play this year?
Besides fucking Fossil Fighters 2. Or Yokai Jam or whatever it's called. Oh, a tennis game.
Ooh, this is cool.
Dude, she's big.
Oh, she's so big. Nintendo One.
Guys, calm down.
Giant Peach! Now where's Giant Sonic?
Yeah, Smash.
That's an amiibo too. Slightly bigger. Finally! We get a tennis game this year. Probably get delayed.
Hopefully it's fucking online.
Probably get delayed.
We've been working together for 30 years now.
Oh, I thought you were going to say 30 years on the project.
Yeah.
Damn. We picked the same one.
As the years went on,
can we get something new?
More and more side-scrolling
nope.
Games. We had to fine. Create a more advanced tool to design them with.
Really? Mario Maker again?
This became the basis of Super Mario Maker.
The tool got so, right, so it is called Super Mario Maker.
The more we worked with it, the more we realized we could also
I just keep saying the name wrong.
Everyone could enjoy. Yeah. With Super Mario Maker.
I never said the name to get it wrong because I don't care.
This instant feedback can really help your imagination run wild. Back in the day, we had to create everything by hand. To design courses, we would actually draw them one at a time onto these sheets of graph paper.
Cool. Time to check my email.
We then send our drawings to the programmers, who would code them into a build. While digging up these old documents, we found this.
Video games are for children, Miyamoto. It's very precious. Thanks, Christian. Confirm for Smash.
The idea of Super Mario Brothers.
Dude, what's if they put Shigeru Miyamoto in Smash? Air and sea. That'd be cool.
He'd be OP.
See this old sketch of Mario throwing
fire. Meji's like the worst player. You can now do that in Super Mario Maker. Some be getting fired. Cloud flies.
In the old days, when we needed to fix or change part of the course, it would get really messy if we tried to edit the original drawing. So we'd put this see-through paper on top to make edits. A lot of things
might
look familiar. Okay. But you can combine various elements from the different games to create entirely new stuff. Like stacking different enemies on top of each other to make a huge tower, and then putting a bullet bill on top.
Mario Party tray load error. Mario Party low ink.
Can we get Mario Party 11? That'd be good.
You can even put things
Mario Party 11?
Water.
Yeah, it'll fix 10 right, by making it worse.
That don't normally appear underwater. Like Goombas.
It's usually what the when Mario Party series thinks it needs
Super
to do.
Mario Maker, it will swim like a small shrimp. Mario can even take on the appearance of other characters. Tap a compatible amiibo, like Wii Fit Trainer, and Mario can turn into Wii Fit Trainer when he gets a mystery mushroom.
Yeah, but she's not as hot as she is in Smash.
We have a lot of these planned. To celebrate Super Mario's 30th anniversary,
I like that. She jumps and goes,
There it is.
Oh my fuck. That's a huge motherfucker.
You guys know about this one? To
reflect the effect. I don't care.
Yeah.
You think I fucking follow AmiiboNews.com?
Yes.
You're right.
That thing's gonna be like $20. It's really
fun just looking. Yeah, it looks like it comes with a book. As if this is what would happen if you design the world of Mario in real life. In real life.
When I have 17 Mario Amiibo, let's do it.
Oh, no, they're not going to do a 3D/2D Mario, are they?
I start by making a course I want to play, which is usually like 2-1 or 2-2. Once that's done, we try to make it a little easier. So we move on to making 1-1.
Oh, that's Chris. I thought that was a cool looking amiibo. I may come
across as a mean. Or the 8-bit? Yeah, I like it. But in
1-1, so it looks ugly. Goomba, which
is clearly he looks ugly. Look at him. Also
a super yeah, mushroom, him and his fucking big ass teeth.
God damn it.
What?
You run, but there's a block above, so you can't run. So if you jump, the ceiling is low, so you usually hit it.
Yeah. Good point, I guess.
But when you do, you grow big. It's a surprise.
What the fuck?
Surprise.
There are stairs.
You hit a block and sometimes a thing comes out. If you didn't know.
But the first gap has a floor. And the second one is the one you want to avoid because it's bottomless. So it's a tutorial in a sense. We put a lot of thought into those types of things.
When playing a Mario game for the first time, it's a challenge to run and jump at the same time. New players usually fall into the first pit because they can't make the jump. But they learn from it. They usually fall into it because they can't make it.
It's like game design training software.
Try it if you want to get into game design.
When does it come out? Exactly, I don't care.
With enough practice, anyone can become a good course designer.
That wasn't even funny. Oh my God! 11th of September. Dude,
bad day.
I'm gonna make a 9/11.
No, God damn it! No,
what in memory?
Don't say it.
In memory.
Don't say it.
No, I'm just gonna make it so I can climb up and go. Ah, remember when these things were here? House live at E3 begins. Come on, that's not bad.
Is that it?
Please no.
I think that was it.
Flying through. Wow. Fox Zero. I thought EA was bad. Can't wait to get your hands on Super Mario Maker. The opportunity is right in front of you. How?
On Wednesday,
in front of
from
me.
4 p.m. to 9 p.m. and Saturday from noon until 5 p.m. local time, you can walk into any of more than 100 Best Buy stores
more than 100.
In the U.S. and Canada.
How's that right in front of
and
me?
And experience the game for yourself firsthand.
I was gonna say I could play it on my
you can
computer.
Find the details of all of our activities this week at E3. Nintendo.
He's gonna do one more thing. Yeah, probably.
To close.
Yeah.
As anyone transforms, be it a person or a company, it's good to reflect on where you've been to help guide where you go next. Over the past 30 years, more than 1 billion people around the world have played a Nintendo game.
Okay.
And most of them have played as gaming's biggest star, Mario.
Oh, fuck.
From the music to the costumes, to the characters.
Mario.
Super Mario isn't just Nintendo's mascot. There's a little piece of him, and certainly memories of his adventures, inside all of us.
What? Oh, cheater. Oh, fuck off, kid. Really? Oh, people like Mario? No shit. What the fuck?
Dude, they better show Mini Wheat in this montage.
They better show the Mega 64 video. Mini Wheat? Fucking hate Mini Wheat. I love him so much. What the fuck, really? Why? Why did he jump in a pool? Was that Robin
it's
Williams' daughter?
Hey, oh fuck, it's Beyond Good and Evil 2.
Yeah. How about you eat my ass? Oh, dog's love!
I was so confused for that split second. Like, why is there a dog?
Oh, selfie cam. Fuck.
I hope that kid falls down.
Ah, yeah, fuck it. Was that Zelda? I mean, Zelda. was that Robin Williams' daughter? Someone said it was. I didn't even notice.
They got the maracas.
Miyamoto was pissed. He just ruined it.
Yeah, he's in face.
Break the guitar over his head.
That was it?
That was it? I thought it would be fucking new. Oh, put up your own video so they could put fucking money copyrights on it. I swear to God.
Now it's your turn.
No.
Visit letsupermario.com and help us celebrate his 30th anniversary by submitting your
Please
own
Please tell
Super
us how
Mario
great we are.
And do it for a good cause, with Nintendo making a donation to the nonprofit group Operation Smile. Visit our site for details. Let's have some fun, let's support a great cause, and let's Super Mario.
We just watched, goddamn.
Yes, watch more of this. I mean, it's cool, I guess, but... Why? Why end it with this? Did you see all those fire bars? I guess I didn't. Operation Smile, you won't be smiling after you see they're gonna charge you $60 for Mario Maker. What the fuck? Is this Treehouse now?
Hello everyone, I'm Shigeru Miyamoto. Thank you for watching Nintendo Digital Event. 日本の皆さん、遅くまでありがとうございます。今日のね、デジタルイベントの映像っていうのは今年発売できる、それから来年の早い時期に発売する。Oh,
Sam wants to come. So, our digital event today focused entirely on games that are launching in 2015 and early 2016.
Is that it?
Yep. Oh, Sam is busy watching Republicans.
No, he called me. Get him in here. Last year, we
have many games. They're terrible. They're the worst.
Well, actually, I'd probably agree with him. Star Fox and then nothing. It was like EA all over again. Well, Mass Effect. Now let's show you sports. They might as well just show me sports.
And so we've
replaced the sports
games
with anime.
That use Amiibo and games like Splatoon, and we've shown Star Fox for this year, and we've got more coming.
Aonuma-san
is not here.
Miyamoto-san.
Someone
is commenting about the fact that Mario Maker is being released on 9/11.
Yeah.
And someone commented, jet fuel can't melt Mario.
What's up?
Or do you like that 3DS conference?
And so now what we're going to do is jump right into gameplay.
What was the 3DS
conference? Oh, cool. There's gameplay going on, though.
Gameplay of what?
We should have
Star Fox.
Nintendo Treehouse Live staff.
Yeah, well, we already seen enough gameplay.
They're probably going to be a lot better than I am.
Oh, dude, the, the box for Mario Maker is yellow.
Yeah, I saw that.
What was coming out this year?
That Pokemon ripoff, I think, comes out this year.
Mario Tennis,
and Star Fox. Yeah, Mario
Xenoblade,
Maker.
It's Xenoblade, Star Fox, Mario Maker, and Tennis.
So only a fraction of what both Sony and Microsoft have.
Well, to be fair, Sony and Microsoft didn't have many exclusives. If you just wanted to combine.
Yeah, but guess what?
Never forget the legacy of Mario, September 11th.
Remember, you can't play. Remember, you can't play any of those on fucking Wii U, though. Sam.
I know you can't play any of them on Wii U, but I mean, at the same time, if you compare first-party games to first-party games, Nintendo had almost like 20 times as much as Sony and Microsoft.
Because they only have first-party.
Any first-party games coming out this year?
For what?
Who?
The biggest thing about the Sony conference that people miss is like only like four of those games are coming out this year. Like all of them are coming out next year.
So only four games are coming out this year for Nintendo.
Yeah. So there you go.
I was talking about quality. Star Fox will be good, and that's it.
Here, aren't they?
Huh?
No.
A lot of those 3DS games have to be coming out this year.
No.
Since nope.
The NX is going to be a handheld.
Not even the fucking Hyrule Warriors. Which
no,
is
the
support.
NX is supposed to be just like a hub console.
Hyrule Warriors is just a fucking fucking port. They couldn't bring it out this year.
It's
fucking lying fucking
people are thinking it's like the next evolution of
fucking
like
stupid
3DS and Wii U.
So dumb.
So, but what is it going to be? Is it going to be?
We don't know. We have
it's
no going to
be a bigger gamepad. Oh,
it's all speculation at the moment.
It's going to be a fucking handheld.
I don't think so. I don't see
why. Why? The 3DS is old as shit.
Like, dude, the majority of these 3DS games they showed are early next year.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Give the 3DS one hell of a year before you fucking shoot it in the head.
I don't see that happening.
Well, to be fair, Sony already did that with PS Vita.
Yeah, I mean.
But they're not going to give one hell of a year.
Yeah, PS is pretty old, Adrian.
It doesn't matter, though. It's
3DS happened. Isn't that old.
Yeah, they've been
4 years.
6 years old next
no, it's not. What the fuck? Came out in 2011.
It came, mine says 2010 on it, so.
There's a reason all Wii U stuff is all like just this year, and that's it.
You got it from Japan then, if you got it from 2010.
Pretty sure it came out in 2010.
What?
Let's see.
You know, Google
no,
is.
No, the 3DS did not come out in 2010.
Came in 2011, I know, because that's when
yep.
I got it.
Let me see.
No, it wasn't 2010. I was
2011
not, I was,
everywhere.
Yeah, I was in El Paso when
Yeah, it released in 2011.
Yeah. Oh, I'm right. Oh no, shit.
Why the fuck does my back of my 3DS say 2010 then?
Because
probably copyright reasons.
Fucking idiot. Because you're looking at your DS.
Attempt to put the previous year on there.
Because you're looking at your DS, you idiot.
Oh.
Yeah. He is. This game looks great. I just want a new
PDS says Metroid copyright game. 2010, and then
there you go.
All right, well, Nintendo sucked. No big surprise.
It's still pretty old. Nah, I mean, they could make another one if they wanted.
You said 6 years.
They did. They made
the
new 3DS.
No, but I mean, they could make a new handheld. And
they're not going to.
Why wouldn't they?
Not next year.
I mean, 3DS sales,
not
I
next year.
Imagine, have staggered.
No, it's been selling pretty well.
No, they just put out an article saying, like, how well it was selling.
I imagine it's going to be a handheld.
It's not.
Why wouldn't it be?
The reason they announced it was to show people, hey, we're still in the fucking console-making business. They're banning the Wii U next year.
No.
They're banning the Wii U.
They're abandoning it. They're like, that's done. Get out.
You're banned.
I imagine a handheld would be better. It'd be better for them to just, like, abandon the console industry entirely.
They're not going to.
I don't think this is a reimagining of Star Fox.
This is the last generation. Like, I don't know why people are...
It's selling too well. It's not going to be a last generation.
Is the last generation.
It's not. They're selling all really
no
well.
No one's making money, Adrian.
Doesn't matter.
Well.
It'll make money. They're selling well.
Is Sam going to be wrong again?
Nobody's.
All right, let's mark it.
Nobody's.
June 16, 2015, last console generation.
He was wrong twice in a row.
Well, Nintendo might make one more. I don't see Sony's going to go bankrupt before they can make another one.
Oh, my God.
And Microsoft.
How's Sony going to go bankrupt?
Sony's been going bankrupt for a long time.
Uh-huh.
They're only making money on PlayStation. That's it.
That's why we should abandon it.
Yeah, let's abandon PlayStation.
I see Sony spinning off PlayStation as its own company, selling it to Samsung or some shit, and then folding
it. No, they'll sell it to Microsoft.
Maybe.
Microsoft's that PlayStation 4. That's going to be amazing.
They'll sell it off to anyone.
I'll shit on everyone's face. That was a Sony fanboy. I'll shit on them.
They need to do something because
they'll probably just get rid of the PS4 and get all the exclusives
onto
their system.
They're very close to going bankrupt. Like, it's not.
I highly doubt it, but okay.
What do you mean you highly doubt it? Sony's been going.
That means I don't think that's true.
Sony's been in financial troubles for like 6 years now.
Yeah, exactly. They would have died by now.
Yeah, the PlayStation 4 is like the thing that saved them.
There you go. And it's still selling well, so it'll be fine.
If the PlayStation 4 didn't do well, yeah, they'd be bankrupt by now. The Vita almost killed them.
Yeah, it's funny that you're the motherfucker that owns a PS4 and you're saying Sony's going bankrupt. They fucked.
Yeah,
Sony fanboy over here.
Like, that's the truth of the matter is that. Sony is on the verge of bankruptcy.
Well, you're not giving them any hope. They're like, I hope they don't go bankrupt. No, they're going bankrupt. They fucked.
Oh, they're gonna go bankrupt eventually.
Yeah.
They're they're losing so much on the music and movie business that it's not even funny. They had to close up their TV business and their laptop business. And the Walkman is on its last legs. And so is their telephone business. They're going to sell Ericsson. So they're like, Sony is, the PlayStation is the only division making money. Everything else is
done. You just said they weren't making money.
Yeah, but that's, they're going to have to sell it. And I'm going to tell you right now, whoever they sell it to, they're going to keep the PlayStation 4 alive, but making another console is such a heavy investment, they're probably not going to.
They will.
End of the PlayStation.
This is end of video games.
Yep. Nintendo will be the only one left.
Handhelds are going to be the future.
And you know, I heard that it's moving to the mobile market.
Yeah, that's
what I've heard that for about 7 years.
It's all going to be on cell phones.
I can't wait to play Pokemon on my iPhone.
You should get a job at Polygon, Sam. You say the same things as them every day.
You know, I heard they're going to stop making Zelda, and they're only going
to
make Angry Birds.
I had to break it to you.
In terms of profits, the mobile industry already owns the video game industry. It's making
sense. I remember when you said the 3DS is going to die at launch.
It is dead. Are you fucking kidding me? It's bullshit. It's dead. There's no money.
They just put out an article like 5 days ago that I read saying like how many millions and millions of units they sold of the new.
Yeah, they sold 60 million units. The iPhone outsells that in 1 day, and it took them fucking 6 years.
Christian said their movies are the most profitable.
Their movies for them.
They should. Yeah, I was gonna play Grand Theft Auto, but instead I picked up Tiny Tower, and it was like, fuck it.
Oh, fuck the game with story. I got Tiny Tower.
Classic.
Fuck effort.
Even any video game of last year.
Fuck effort. No one needs it.
I was gonna play Destiny, but then I played Flappy Bird.
But then I died.
And,
I'm pretty sure Clash of Clans made more money than Destiny.
I'm sure Game of War did, because fucking they had that big titty girl. Woo!
Yeah, I'm sure they did too. I'm not even exaggerating.
We should just all make a shitty iOS game that probably doesn't work well.
It'll be like crowded by hundreds and hundreds of other games.
We'll get another big titty bitch to be like, hey, I have big titties, let's play.
Hey, Samuel, you want to be our big titty bitch?
It has low overhead. Like, anyone can make an iOS game. That's why it's profitable.
It's not profitable. It's way too saturated. It's way too saturated.
You would saturated?
It's extremely saturated. It is like a 1 in 100,000 chance you're going to be the one person that actually gets it. You hear about the success more than the failures. No one does it.
I'm going to kill myself.
Yeah, indie developers may be failing, but Sega, all the ones that have transitioned over are doing fine. Sega's way more money.
Sony's going to shut down. Sega will win.
No one cares. No one cares if I kill myself.
I'm surprised we didn't hear about Sonic Boom, whatever. 2?
It already got announced, you stupid fuck.
Yeah, but we didn't hear about it in Nintendo's conference.
Of course you wouldn't, because they're not that stupid.
Where's the next Sonic in the Olympic Games?
They already announced that before E3. Because they had so much E3 news that they did a Nintendo Direct before E3. And they announced it. That's not a joke. I don't know why everybody got quiet. Hello?
Hi.
Matt's getting all off and trying to call me.
Who?
Matt.
He's in the chat. He wants to come in, but I don't know. No, I don't know.
He says, tell Adrian to get over himself.
Yeah, that's a good way to... Yeah, that'll work.
Oh, I'm okay now.
Oh, he's right.
I'm looking in the mirror right now. I'm deciding whether I want to or not.
All right. Well, that was Nintendo.
My reflection.
So now, Square Enix just start?
Only Wii U owners allowed.
Wait, hold on. Square Enix just started. I think.
Square Enix might be actually pretty good this year.
Yeah, but hold on. I think it's just started like 4 minutes ago.
Well.
I'm watching it only for Bravely Second.
Well, yeah, you better watch it now. They might be showing it.
Man, I can't wait to buy this game again.
None of the streams are showing it right now.
900 people are watching this.
It's not on, I don't think.
Oh, okay, it's a little late yet. Okay. I'm watching it through game trailers. I thought this was their official.
You fund Shenmue 3, even though we're a multi-billion dollar corporation. Fuck that.
No, I agree with that. Wait,
does Twitch have their own stream for Square Enix?
I just wanted
to... Sony. Fuck Sony. I'm so pissed at that.
You pissed at what?
You don't have $3 million, Sony, to give fucking Shenmue?
What?
You just said that they're going bankrupt. Like,
how? The call-outs.
Could have funded Shenmue.
Jesus
himself.
Christ, you fucking idiot.
$3 million.
That's what we have sports gear for.
$3 million is nothing to fund a project like
it's
that.
It's just do that with a billion different projects. I'm sure it'll work out.
Yeah, I'm sure it'll be fine.
They don't have any. They're not making any other fucking games.
Oh, you're right. I think it started. Something started. All right, so that was Nintendo.